They really only tested one area. As one guy put it, they didn't do three tests. They did one test three times.
There are literally thousands of pieces of scientific data which support the conclusion that the Shroud is not a fake or forgery. However, only one piece of evidence, the carbon 14 dating, indicates the Shroud is of medieval origin. In my professional opinion, the authenticity of the Shroud could be proven in a court of law beyond a reasonable doubt.
Of the extensive objective scientific tests performed on the Shroud, the preponderance favored authenticity. Except for the carbon 14 dating tests, which the scientific community agrees are not always error-free, the Shroud of Turin appears to be a genuine burial cloth from the time of Christ. But it is the image on this cloth from which the final judgment will have to be made. What made it? Whose image is it? How did it get on the cloth and remain still visible after more than 1,000 years?
Whatever the mechanism for forming the image on the Shroud, it had to occur in a short period of time, act in an up and down direction, and produce an image intensity determined by the distance between the cloth and the body. One of the theories which seems to satisfy these characteristics is a coronal discharge similar to Curlian photography or lightning.
One scientist said it's like every pore of the body suddenly fired a miniature laser beam for a split second of time. And so I'm sure that there's some power, some explanation that defies our current understanding.
And I believe that when the body of Christ was raised to that multi-dimension that scientists call in-space, that there was a little extra burst of radiation that marked the Shroud.
Just maybe God did leave behind a document of the resurrection.
Well, remembering that I'm Jewish, so that I certainly don't have any biases for the cloth, and as a matter of fact was very skeptical at the beginning, I still believe the Shroud is authentic, because there's really no way to duplicate the quality of the image that we have there today.
Is there any way that one can know without a doubt that the Shroud of Turin is authentic? I don't think so. I think it will always remain a mystery, and maybe that's the way it should be.
If you have faith, you don't need the Shroud, and if you don't have faith, it's questionable whether you'll be convinced by it. But if it makes you think about it, if it makes you consider it, then it's important.
Even Einstein said that there are dimensions beyond that which we understand.
The Shroud of Turin, at this time anyway, continues to be one of the great mysteries of the modern world. If authentic, it is the greatest, most wondrous relic of all time. If not, it is equally the greatest, most wondrous enigma of all time. There is no in-between. It is one or the other. And that makes the Shroud newsworthy for tomorrow's headlines, as the world anxiously awaits additional scientific proof.